G'day and welcome back to Build Some, and this is video 3 in the 4-part series on how to get the length of your hip. And in this video we're going to look at probably the least popular way, which is actually calculating it. So to calculate it, we need a few dimensions. So obviously we need to know what the roof pitch is and at least what our half span of the building is. So in this case we've got a 30 degree pitch roof and our half span is 2.5 meters. So with that information we can start to work out what we need. So we need to know that the rise of our roof per meter is 577 millimeters. Okay, so what we do is we go 10 times the pitch of the roof will give us that answer. So 10 times 30 will give us 0.577. So for every metre that the roof runs, it rises 577 mil. So that's all right for the rafters, but we need to look at the actual hips. So there's a bit of closer detail. Every metre that way, roof rises 577 mil. Now, for the hip itself, if we have a square that's a metre by a metre, then we need to know this distance here, where the hip's going to run, 45 degrees to the corner. So, a bit of Pythagoras, metre squared plus a metre squared equals 2, square root of 2 is 1.414. So the plan length of the hip for every metre this way, the plan length of the hip is 1 meter 414. Okay, and at the same point it would rise the same distance, so the hip is obviously at a fraction different angle to our main roof, so it's not 30 degrees down here, it's slightly less, but the same rise at the same point. So the formula there is, so the true length of the hip for every metre this way is 1.527 on that angle up there. Okay, so what we've done there, we've gone Pythagoras again with our 1.414 squared plus our rise squared gave us 2.332, square root that gives us a distance of 1.527. So that means for every metre of run we have 1.527 metres of our hip. So now we know that formula, we can transfer that into the whole roof, and we know that our half span was 2.5. So we can times that by 1.527 and gives us a hip length of 3.818 from the intersection of the crown end rafter and the centering rafter down to a point in line with the back of our plate. Gives us 3.818 metres. So that's the centre line length. We haven't made any deductions yet. We now have to make a couple of deductions. So up at our intersection of our ridge, our centering rafters and our crown end rafter, obviously this is where our centre line meets in the middle here. We have to deduct this much off the length of our hip. But because we're really worried about our half span, we're going to deduct this distance here off our half span. So this rafter happens to be a 35 mil rafter, so half of 35 is 17.5. So we're going to deduct 17.5 off our half span to give us the true length of our hip. We also have to do the same at the bottom end, because in a lot of cases we cut the corner off our plate so our hip fits nicely with the bird's mouth. So we've got a 20, we're going to say we've got a 20 millimeter hip that's going to go in here. So this little tab's been cut off 20 mil. So that means if we take half of that distance, which is 10 mil, times 10 mil by our ratio of 1.414, okay, it gives us 0.01414. Divide that by 2, it gives us 7 mil, right, which is this distance here. So we've got to take a further 7 mil off the plate down here, or off the length. So what we do, this is our new plan length, we take our 2.5, which is our original half span, we minus the 7 mil for the deduction down here at the plate, and we minus 17.5 mil for the deduction up at the ridge. So that gives us a total deduction of 24.6 mil, or you can round that up to 25. So 2.5 minus 25 mil gives you a new plan length of 2.475. Take that, times it by our length per meter for the hip, and we end up with a new length of our hip of 3.779 meters so far. That's the new length, allowing for our deductions. Okay, we can then work out the actual true length of the timber with our overhang as well. So to work out our overhang, we have to go back to add our plate deduction back on, and then add the width of the eave back on. Okay, so we take our 2.475, add our plate deduction back on, which was 7 mil, add our eave overhang back on, or on, not back on, which is 450, gives us a new overall plan length of 2.932, times that by our little factor of 1.527, and that gives us a total length of our hip of 4.477 meters. So now we know all the dimensions we need to know to mark out our actual hip. So what we can do is we can go over to our hip material, mark and cut our hip end. Go back, show you that. So I've marked it, put the edge bevels on there, and then from the very point of our edge bevels, we're going to measure down the timber. We're going to measure down our 2.475. Put a mark, draw in the angle, making sure we also draw in our stand up for our bird's mouth. That'll give us the position of our bird's mouth for our hip. So we can cut that out. We can then add on for our plate deduction. Well, we don't need to add it on, we've already worked it out. We can then measure a further 4.477 to our point of our tail, and we can cut the tail off. And then of course we can test fit it, and yeah, if it works well and good, we can check it for the other positions, and then we can fit all our hips. So there you go, that's how we calculate the length of our hip, and as you can see, that's probably why it's not such a popular method.